Thank you, Chairman Nadler. Mr. Floyd, thank you for being here today and for those incredibly powerful words, and we are so sorry. Chairman Nadler, Ranking Member Collins, and members of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to testify today. And thank you, Chairman Nadler, for calling this hearing on policing practices and the need for transformative policies that promote accountability, begin to reimagine public safety, and respect the dignity of all people. While the recent murder of George Floyd at the hands of four Minneapolis police officers put the issue of police brutality in the national spotlight, the outpouring of pain and anger is anything but a reaction to one isolated incident or the misconduct of a few bad apples. Instead, the outcry is a response to the long cycle of stolen lives and violence with impunity toward Black people in our nation. We are now at a turning point. There is no returning to normal. We have to create a new way forward, one that does more than tinker at the edges, that promotes data and training. We need something that truly transforms policing and leads to more accountability for communities. It is imperative that we get this right, and that Congress's response in this moment appropriately reflects and acknowledges the important work of Black Lives Matter, the movement for Black Lives, and so many people that are bringing us to this tipping point. My tenure as head of the Justice Department Civil Rights Division began 2 months after 18-year-old Michael Brown was killed by a police officer in Ferguson. The Justice Department was hardly perfect, but we understood our mandate to promote accountability and constitutional policing in order to build community trust. During the Obama administration, we opened 25 pattern or practice investigations to help realize greater structural and community-centered change, often at the request of police chiefs and mayors who needed federal leadership. After making findings, we negotiated consent decrees with extensive engagement and input from community advocates who not only identified unjust and unlawful policing practices, but also helped develop sustainable mechanisms for accountability and systemic change. That is not the Justice Department that we have today. Under both Attorneys General Jeff Sessions and Bill Barr, the department has abdicated its responsibility and abandoned the use of tools like pattern practice investigations and consent decrees. Instead, it is focused on dismantling police accountability efforts and halting any new investigations. The disruption of crucial work in the Civil Rights Division and throughout the Department of Justice to bring forth accountability and transparency in policing is deeply concerning. In the absence of federal leadership, the Leadership Conference Education Fund launched the New Era of Public Safety Initiative, a comprehensive guide and toolkit outlining proposals to build trust between communities and police departments, restore confidence, and imagine a new paradigm of public safety. While much of these changes must happen at the state and local level, success is going to require the leadership, support, and commitment of the federal government, including Congress. Last week, the Leadership Conference and more than 400 civil rights organizations sent a letter to Congress to move us forward on a path of true accountability. The recommendations included the following. One, create a national necessary standard on the use of force. Two, prohibit racial profiling, including robust data collection. Three, ban the use of chokeholds and other restraint maneuvers. Four, end the militarization of policing. Five, prohibit the use of no-knock warrants, especially in drug cases. Six, strengthen federal accountability systems and increase the Justice Department's authority to prosecute officers that engage in misconduct. Seven, create a national police misconduct registry. And eight, end qualified immunity. The Leadership Conference was pleased to learn that the Justice and Policing Act introduced Monday by both members of the House of Representatives and the Senate reflects much of this accountability framework. This is Congress's most comprehensive effort in decades to substantially address police misconduct by taking on issues, critical issues affecting Black and Brown communities. And as the bill advances toward passage, we will continue to work on it and to ensure that real change is achieved. But let me just say in closing that policing reform alone is not going to solve the crisis that we're in today. This moment of reckoning requires leaders, together with communities, to envision a new paradigm of public safety that respects the human rights of all people. That means not just changing policing practices and culture, but ultimately shrinking the footprint of the criminal legal system in Black and Brown people's lives. And it means shifting our approach to public safety from exclusively focusing on criminalization and policing towards investments in economic opportunity, education, healthcare, and other public benefits. Police chiefs and officers talk about the same thing. This approach will not only further equity, but also constitute effective policy. When we stop using criminal justice policy as social policy, we will make communities safer and more prosperous. Now is the time for Congress to pass lasting accountability measures, and we look forward to working with you until the day that these reforms are signed into law. George Floyd's death has impacted the world, and now it is on us to change it. Thank you.